Hello, how are you? How are you? Are you fine? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can we start? Yes? Can we start? Hello? Okay, so today we are going to watch some presentations that some of you made about their magnificent presentations. Some of them are fantastic, and we are going to start with the Valencian community. And this presentation was made by Victor, your fellow mate. And this is interesting because this is the place where you had gone if in normal circumstances. And here you can see this this has become a symbol of the Valencian community. So this is the city of arts and science. And this is a building, this is a monument that was made by Calatrava, Santiago Calatrava, one of the most famous architects and artists in contemporary Spain. You can see here, this is a kind of museum, planetarium, and this is the Opera House of Valencia. Very good, very good. And here you have the map, you know, this is Valencia, Comunidad Valenciana, okay, with the provinces. This is Castellón, Valencia, and Alicante, okay, and is located south of Catalonia and Aragon, and east of Castilla-La Mancha and Murcia. Good. And so this is the Valencian flag, very similar to the Catalonian flag, to the Aragonese flag, to the Balearic flag. And these are the provinces. Total population is more or less 5 million people there. Okay, very good. And this is the coat of arms of Valencian community, the coat of arms. Okay. And this is the symbol here. Can you see this kind of crown? This is the symbol of Jaume the First of Aragon, one of the most important kings in the Middle Ages. In Aragon, and you can see here, this is the shield. This is the shield. This is the same. I repeat, the same as the one you can find in Aragon, Catalonia, and the Balearic Islands. Okay, so this is an autonomous community in Spain, and this is the building, the palace, where the Valencian government has its place. Okay. Government and the parliament. You know that the parliament in the Valencian community is called la Generalitat Valenciana. Okay, they speak dialect from Catalan, and this is called Catalan. Sorry, the Valencian dialect, but this is a variation of Catalan. Good. These are the provinces. Remember, Castellón is the name of the province, but the city is called Castellón de la Plana. Not the same. Castellón, just Castellón for the province, and the city, Castellón de la Plana. Valencia, Alicante. And this special territory belongs to the province of Valencia, and belongs to this community. Okay, this is called Ademuz. And this is Valencia. This is not the province, this is just the city. You can see here, this is very interesting, a map. This is very interesting, and you have here the Roman wall. You know that Valencia was founded by the Romans. Okay, there was the extension of the Roman city of Valencia, not very important at the moment. Okay, what most important were Merida, were Zaragoza at the time, but Valencia was founded by the Romans, and then was conquered by the Muslims, and this another war belongs to this age, and this is the Christian war. You know that there is a very important character in the history of Spain called El Cid Campeador. El Cid Campeador was able to conquer Valencia, okay? But then the Muslims reconquered it. And this part in green, this is the river Turia. River Turia. Good. And as for Castellón, you have here two very interesting places, okay? So you have here Peñíscola, this is a castle. This is a castle, and this is the wall. This castle has a history that is very interesting. In that castle there was a pope, a Spanish pope, that was here. There was a time where there were several popes at the same time. One of them was a Spaniard, okay? Here, this is Morella, you look here, this is the town, very steep town. Had to be this way because of defensive reasons. Very good. And this is Alicant. And this is a place, a beautiful city. It's in the coast. Castellón is in the coast, on the coastline, and Valencia has a coastline as well. And Calpe, you have here a rock. Maybe you remember Gibraltar. Same place. This is a rogue. It's a kind of island, but this is not an island, this is a peninsula, a little peninsula, because this part joins this rock with the continent. This is called Isthmus, you remember? Very good. There are many places to visit. This is the City of Arts and Science, and this is part as well of the same complex. So this is the opera house, this is a kind of planetarium, a science museum, okay, and many other buildings here. The Oceanographico, the Oceanographic here. You can see a lot of animals, marine animals. And place to visit. So this is Valencia, this is the cathedral, okay, an imposing cathedral. Okay. This is Baroque style in this part, but this tower is a mix between Gothic style and Mudéjar style. Can you see here? This is the plant. Looks like a cross. Can you see here? Like a cross. Very interesting. These are the gates of Valencia. Okay, this place. Can see that. I hope you can go there. Good, very good. And some people that were born there, one of them was Joaquín Sorolla. You know many things about Joaquín Sorolla. There is a museum, a house museum, very near the school in Martínez Campos Street, Madrid. You can go there, you have to go there, okay, because there are many pictures by this magnificent painter. You remember, he was an impressionist painter. These are people, two women, that are going for a walk. This is the sea, the beach. Very good. You can see the light here. Very good. And this is the this is the Pope. This is the Pope that I talked about before, okay? Some of them. Very good. This is another interesting artist, in this case, Vicente Blasco Ibáñez, a writer, an important writer in his time. He was born in Valencia. Typical meals, you know, paella valenciana. This is worldwide famous. Okay, very good. It's we have here rice, horchata, chufa. Interesting. And beaches, you name it. So Terra Nova, Esterrer, Lago de Mar, many of them. It's very good. Sorry, this is Artai. So what's my mistake? Sorry. Not Victor Bar, but Artai. And this is a very interesting image about Fallas. Okay. Very good. So thank you, Artai. And now we want to watch another interesting presentation. Oh, it doesn't work. Sorry. Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, La Rioja, and that was made by Nico. So, La Rioja is an inland autonomous community, an uniprovincial autonomous community. Okay. And here you can see here this border. This border is made by Ebro River. And Logroño is the capital city of the autonomous community. And this is the location. You can see here. Okay, this is inland, an inland autonomous community, uniprovincial, as well as Asturias, Cantabria, Madrid, Murcia. Good. And the borders are Castilla y León, Navarra, Aragon, as you can see, a little part of Álava that belongs to the Basque Country. Good. This is the flag. It's a new flag, okay? Official flag since this year. Okay, you remember that in 1978 the Spanish Constitution was approved. So the next year was the flag. This is the coat of arms. And this coat of arms is interesting because it represents, well, this is a crown, so, and that means that we are living in a monarchy, in a parliamentary monarchy. So this is the symbol of the parliamentary monarchy. And you have here the coat of arms divided into two parts. And here on your right you have this river. This river is Ebro River. And this part is a hint to the St. James Way, Camino de Santiago, because the St. James Way has a little part crossing Logroño into La Rioja. Good. You can hear, this is interesting, pay attention to this map, because the name of the autonomous community is La Rioja. This is the Ebro, okay, this is the Ebro, and this is one shore of the Ebro. This is the Basque Country, you know. This is Navarra. This is Aragon, in part. Very good. And you have here some tributaries of the Ebro River. Okay. If the river goes this way, okay, this is the right part, and the other is the left part. So there are some tributaries that come from Pyrenees, and these are the left bank of the river, and this is the other bank. And you have many rivers here, but here, attention, you have a tributary, not very important, but apparently this river, this small river, is called Oja, and people said Rioja. You understand? And that's the name of the entire autonomous community, just because of the name of this river. This is a very interesting river, because all along this river there's a lot of crops. Many people were living out of agriculture, and this river was very important for them. This Rioja, this is the region of Rioja, and for extension the whole autonomous community is called Rioja, just because of the name of this river. Very good. And you have here some rivers. This is Ebro River, okay, the Seven Valleys, okay, Alhama, Cidacos, many of them, okay. And you have here some mountains. To the south of this autonomous community, there is the Sierra de la Demanda, there is an area called Cameros. Many little villages are called Cameros. Camero Viejo, Camero Nuevo. Okay, not only the name of the mountains, but also some villages. Okay, you have here rivers, and you have here a river, another river, and here a mountain. And the river gives the name to a valley. Okay, so many rivers, many chances for agriculture. So that's why agriculture is a very important economic activity for Rioja. You know, so economy in the secondary sector, you have some activities, so textiles, woodwork, and you have wine and vegetables there. You know that Rioja wine is famous in the world. Good. You know that one of the most interesting products of Spain. And interesting things. This is very important. This is Millán de la Cogolla. Millán de la Cogolla is just a monastery. There's two of them. One of them is up this, and the other is down. This is the one that is down. Okay? And they call it Suso and Yuso. Suso is this part, because it's the part that is down. And there is another one that is called Yuso, that is up. Very good. And this is the place when, not where the Spanish language was born, but the place where the written Spanish language was discovered. Good. And some plates, patates a la Riojana, very interesting. And you know this boy, hello Nico, very good. This is the grape vines there. Okay, very good, thank you Nico. And we have time to watch to another, want to find it, to another yes. This is the Autonomous Community of Asturias, and that word was made by ENAI. So this is the location, and you see here another uniprovincial autonomous community in Spain, just in the northern part of the Iberian Peninsula. This is the location, okay, and it borders with Galicia, Castilla León, and Cantabria. Okay. So, and this is the Cantabrian Sea, you remember. So, Oviedo is the capital city of the autonomous community. And this is the cathedral of Oviedo. Oviedo is called Vetusta, just because there was a writer called Leopoldo Alas Clarín that wrote a very interesting novel about a city. And the name was Vetusta. Vetusta was a name for Oviedo. Okay, and you have here some mountain ranges, and these are Picos de Europa. Can you see here? They are legendary mountains there, Picos de Europa. There, and this is historical, because just in these places, this mountainous area, when the Muslims invaded the peninsula, some Christian people, took shelter here, and for the Muslims was very difficult to go after them, and they start making a kind of resistance to the Muslims. Okay, very good. And this is another very interesting mountain. This is called Naranco de Bulnes. It's very difficult to go up here. It's very difficult. So there are some mountaineering people that go there. It is very difficult to climb this peak. And many rivers. You know that Cantabrian and Asturian rivers and Basque rivers are short. They are short, and they carry a lot of flow, a lot of water. And some of them are Nalón, Sella, many of them. This is Eo River. Eo River makes a border between Asturias and Galicia. You have in one place, you have here Lugo, Vegadeo, and on the other place, you have another, the first Asturian town, Castropol, Vegadeo, Castropol, Vegadeo. This is the Eo River. This is the Cantabrian Sea. Okay, there are many of them, and many cities. Some of them are small, and some of them are very important in population. Avilés, Gijón, are very important in population. But you go to Llanes, Cudillero, especially in summer, you're going to find a lot of tourists there. Okay, these are the autonomous symbols, the coat of arms. This is the cross, the Asturian cross. Okay, and this is the flag, blue flag. Okay, it's you have some economic activities. So the primary sector is very important. You know that primary sector is related to the work on the fields. They are working with raw materials, and so you have milk, you have meat. Okay. This is a special race in Asturias, of course. Good. Secondary sector. Fishing is primary sector. Fishing is primary sector, and agriculture is primary sector. Secondary sector is related to, industries, to companies, to industry. And tertiary sector is related to tourism. A lot of people go there to visit Asturias. And reasons to encourage to visit there, this place is beautiful. You can breathe pure air. Yes, no contamination. Because beaches are so nice and clean. Very good, very good. Thank you, Nai, for your contribution. Very good. And now we're going to move east, and we're going to see Cantabria. This is a work that was made by Aaron. A very interesting work. So Cantabria, and this is the location. You can see here Cantabria, Asturias. Okay, we talk about Asturias just a moment ago, and this is Cantabria, and these are provinces that belong to Castilla-León. Okay, and this part here is the Basque Country. Now we are going to see something about Cantabria, and this is the map. Can you see here another very mountainous region, just like the Basque Country and Asturias? So Cantabria was the place where some Celt tribes were independent. And you remember the first Roman Emperor Augustus had to come here to win over them. And every summer, in many places here, in many little villages, they are paying tribute to those tribes, the Cantabrian. They were brave people. They were defeated at the end, okay? But they were very brave people, and they were famous in the Roman world. So famous that the sea was called after them, Cantabrian Sea, just because the people that live here. Brave people, independent people. Okay, and Cantabria, this green valley, this is typical of there. Typical. This is the flag and the coat of arms. The flag is here, so it's white and red, and this is the coat of arms. The coat of arms you can see here a little bit better, and this is the sea that represents the Cantabrian Sea. And this is a kind of fortress, castle, kind of fortress, very difficult to conquer. Cantabria is very difficult to conquer. Good. Many, many interesting things here. This is the mountain range in Cantabria. Okay, they're not very high, not very high. And this is one of them. Okay, this is Gulf, Cantabria. Okay. Interesting. Some rivers. Some rivers. These rivers. Rivers in Cantabria, as in Asturias, Basque Country, they are short, but they carry a lot of water. They carry northwards, and they carry a lot of water there. And this is the Cape. This is the Cape. Cantabria. Interesting. Ajo Cape is the name. You go to see a cape, no matter where you go, normally these capes are surrounded by a territory that normally is a national park. Very interesting. If you like nature, you can go there. Ajo Cape. Very good. This is the president. This is the face of population. Okay. It's the capital city, Santander, as you know. This is Magdalena Palace, Palacio de la Magdalena. Okay. You go to Santander, you have to go here. You have to go here. There are many courses, especially in summer, with the students that flock here to study several things. Many cities, Corrales de Huelma, Torre la Vega, Reynosa. Reynosa is the place where Ebro River is born. Okay, Reynosa, the area of Reynosa. Okay, Fontibre is here. Okay, Laredo, Santoña, Casturdiales. It's economic activities in the primary sector. You have fishing. Fishing, you know that fishing, along with mining and along with agriculture, with raising of cattle, belong to the primary sector here. It's the tertiary sector, tourism. Yes, there are some interesting activities related to food in the secondary sector. Here you have an image about Altamira Caves, but this image doesn't belong to Altamira Cave. Okay, this image belongs, I think, to a cave in France. In Altamira Cave, we have other kind of images. Okay, Santillana del Mar. This photo belongs to Santillana del Mar. You want to visit Altamira Caves, these cave paintings here, you have to go to this village. This is called Santillana del Mar. This is Altamira Cave. Okay, and you see here, so we're talking about the Paleolithic period, and some very interesting artists such as Picasso said that this is the most important piece of art in history. In history. You know that this is known as the Sixtine Chapel of the Paleolithic Arts, La Capilla Sistina. Good. And you can find there some other monuments. This is a monument made by Gaudí. Okay, the modernist architect, Catalan modernist architect, in comillas. Very good. Aaron, very good work. Very good work. So congratulations. And even we have another half time to watch to this magnificent work by Silvia about Euskadi. So pay attention. This is the location of Spain. Today we have been talking about Valencian Community, La Rioja, Asturias, Cantabria, and we are going eastwards, and this is the Basque Country. And it's located, you know, this is the Biscay Bay, this is the Cantabrian Sea, and Castilla y León, La Rioja, Navarra, and Cantabria. And this part touches France here. Okay, very good. So this is the area of the autonomous community, and this is the population. Okay, they're a little less than Madrid city, but the density of population is very high. Not the same as Madrid community, but this is a very high population density there. And you have here the three provinces. So Vizcaya, Mind the spelling. This is Spanish. Vizcaya. This is Spanish. Okay. Guipúzcoa and Álava in Spanish. And you have here the name of the capital cities of the autonomous community. So Bilbao, Bilbao, Bilbo, they say in Euskera. This is the capital city of this province. San Sebastián, in Spanish, you can say Donostia or Donosti. This is the capital city of Gipuzkoa. And Vitoria, in Spanish, Gasteiz, this is Euskera, the capital city both of Álava province and the whole autonomous community. So the capital, sorry, the, sorry. So the whole autonomous community has three provinces, three capitals, but Vitoria-Gasteiz is the capital both of the province of Álava, Álava province, and the entire autonomous community. And this the political structure is somewhat different from many other autonomous communities in Spain, because to start with, they have another language. Okay, they have Euskera. They have to they speak Spanish, as you and me, but they have Euskera, Euskera, Euskara. They have two different languages there. And you know that Euskara language is one of the oldest in the world, oldest than Spanish, than French, than Italian, than English, than German. Okay, and they have a different treatment for historical reasons in the constitution of Spain, and they have a fiscal treatment different from the rest of the provinces. And the provincial council, is something different in the Basque Country. So in the rest of Spain, the councillors in each province aren't elected by universal suffrage, but here in the Basque Country, people have to go to the ballot box to vote for the representatives. Okay, sorry. What is happening? Representatives, and that happens as well in the archipelagos, in the Canary Islands, the Cabildos, and in the Balearic Islands, the insular councils. Good, and this is Álava. Álava is the only Basque province that is not coastal, and this is a very interesting province and very important, especially in agriculture. In the secondary sector, a lot of factories are there. Okay, good. This is Gipuzkoa. You can see here the physical structure of Gipuzkoa. All of these are mountains. So you want to go from one place to another, you have to climb mountains, you have to climb down other mountains. Okay, so that's why you want to go with a car, from a place to another, you have to go through tunnels, a lot of them. This is Vizcaya, this is Bilbao here, this place, Bilbao. This is Cantabria. Okay, very good, very good. This is Castilla y León, Burgos. Okay. Nervión River. This is the Ría of Nervión. In here, you have Bilbao. Very good. Important economic activities is in the Basque Country, especially industry. You have here. A photo about industry. Many people went migrating from Spain, from the rest of Spain, to the Basque Country, looking for a job there. And tourism is very important. You have here, I don't know exactly, but that could be a photo about Donostia, San Sebastián. That could be, not very sure, La Concha Beach. Okay. And this is interesting, Pinchos, gastronomy. You go there especially to San Sebastián, to Donosti, you are going to see this image this image repeated all over again in every bar. Good. And this is the primary sector. This is the primary sector. Agriculture, very important. And this, I think, this could be Bilbao. Not very sure. Good. And Basque Country. Sylvia is encouraging us to visit the Basque Country, and for all my part, same. Many things there. This is the Guernica, but you want to see the Guernica, you don't have to go to the Basque Country. You have to go to Sofia Museum in Madrid. Madrid, Guernica is a place, a very interesting place, a village, a historic village in the Basque Country. And this image, I bet you know, represents the Guggenheim Museum in Bilbao. And many things. This is La Concha Beach in Donosti. Many other Zarauz. Okay, Zarauz is very interesting because some movies, some series, has been set there in Zarauz just because of this landscape. Beautiful landscape. This is La Concha. Very good. And this is the end. This is the end. Thank you, Silvia, for your contribution. It's I think we don't have time enough to see the rest of your presentation. So next day, I promise you, you're going to see the rest of the work of your mates. And thank you for your attention. Thank you to you all, and we are seeing us in just some minutes to do maths. Thank you.